You're an NFL star with the New York Jets right now, not in the playoffs. Who are you rooting for? Who do you think will win it all this year?
I'm not rooting for nobody.
All right, you're keeping it real?
I'm just keeping it real. I'm not rooting for nobody. I'm a fan of football just period. But I think you got four teams to me that stick out the most. That's Seattle, San Fran, and you have Denver and New England. You know, those teams stick out the most to me that could have a chance at going to the Super Bowl all the way.
When you're on the field, who's the one guy you enjoy competing against the most? Who brings the best out of you?
That's every week. It's not just one receiver. I think that's every week. One thing you always want to go out, you want to make sure you go out and give your best every single week. So it's not about a person bringing out the best. It's about you bringing out your best so you can go and go out and dominate that person every single week for me.
Let's talk boxing for a second. Are you a boxing fan at all?
I love boxing. Love boxing.
Floyd Money Mayweather, May 3rd. Amir Khan, Marcos Maidana, Manny Pacquiao.
I want to see the Pacquiao fight, man.
Why?
Everyone else want to talk about Pacquiao against Floyd, that he's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters. And we all know that Floyd is the best pound-for-pound fighter for what he's been doing, and his resume speaks for itself. And, everybody talks about it. That's the fight everybody wants to see. So that's the one I want to see, I think it'll be a great fight.
How impressive is it that Floyd makes 100-something million a fight with no endorsement? Can you believe that?
You know what? I think he does a great job for himself. He knows how to market himself well. Not having a market deal, not anything like that, but he knows how to go about it. He knows the business very well. He's a smart dude that understands everything that goes on.
Floyd is the money team. Antonio, what's your team? If you had to come up with for your own, what would it be?
Oh, man, I don't know, man. It'd just be protein. I don't have anything to deal with money, just the protein. That's it.
It's the off season for you. Yep. What are you going to do for the next 3 months, 4 months?
Honestly, my biggest thing is trying to get myself back into shape, take some time off, spend some time with the family. And then from there, start breaking down film. Understanding what I need to try to do better and how teams are trying to attack me during this past season and work on things like that and try to work harder from there. How are
you? Do you ever see something on tape like, man, I wish I had that game back. I would have done it differently.
No, because everything is a lesson learned. When you go back and you feel like you have to go back and say, I wish I would have did this better, then you didn't go out and give it your all because you're thinking too much. And I think the biggest thing I learned is how to play the position and going out and understanding what teams are trying to do to you is go back and just watch the film of how teams were trying to attack you and understand what they're trying to do and just try to get better from that when you're in practice and in the film room.
You're a professional athlete. When you go to the airport, who do you get confused the most? Who do people always think you are? Like, they want to pick your autograph and...
Nobody, honestly.
They don't always...
No, I'm low-key. See, I put on hats, shades, glasses, a hoodie. I'm trying not to get recognized in the airport.
What's on your iPad? What music do you listen to right now?
I got some Rick Ross, Lil Wayne, and then I have my gospel side with Donna McClurkin, Marvin Sapp, William McDowell, and those guys. So Lecrae and all those. So I listen to a variety of music.
My last question: if you weren't in the NFL, what would you be doing for a career? What's your second passion?
Basketball.
Really?
Yeah. Basketball.
Did the Lakers trade power? No. What do you say?
I think it's gonna happen.
Why?
I don't know. I just think it's gonna happen. I can't tell you why because I really don't understand the reason why. But I think that's what's gonna happen.
Is Carmelo coming to LA?
Not right now. Maybe next year.
How about LeBron? Is he staying in Miami? Or is he coming to the Lakers?
LeBron? No. LeBron is not. I'm a Miami Heat fan, so. No, he's not coming to the Lakers. He either go back to Cleveland or he's going to stay in Miami.
So what is it about? You watch Geno Smith day in and day out in practice. He has some peaks and valleys this season. What did you see that the public does not see about this young man years to come?
Man, I think it's just his attitude towards how he wants to get better every single week. He never takes a day off. He beat me in the building sometimes. He's in the building at 5:45, 6 o'clock in the morning and won't leave until 6 or 7 o'clock at night. It's just the work that he tries to put in. I think the biggest thing for him is understanding what he needs to try to do it's not about, you know, forcing anything, and that's what he did a great job of. I think he's trying to understand the offense a lot more the more and more he played. I think he's the past month it really showed what kind of quarterback that he can be. You know, I think the past two games he didn't have any turnovers, didn't throw any interceptions, and had a pass but quarterback rating over 90 quarterback rating in the last two games. So it just speaks volumes of what can he do. And once we start getting more guys, more playmakers around him, it's going to make things a lot easier for him.
How happy were you to get Rex Ryan back and get the news in the locker room? Big Rex back.
Man, I think everybody was excited, man. I think just having Rex back, it just speaks volumes of what kind of guy he is and the reaction that the players gave once we found out that he was going back. He's the kind of guy that's going to go to bat for his players. So we feel like we have to do the same for him. And one of the main reasons, you know, that he's back is because what kind of guy he is. He's going to get the most out of his players, and he's going to make sure that every single player get the most out of him also.
Now, last question, you're a Miami Heat fan, which is pretty much a two-team race in the East between Are you extremely confident Roy Hibbert and those boys with Paul George against LeBron, D-Wade if he's healthy, and the rest of the Miami boys? Do they have a shot of making history of going back to the NBA Finals and winning it?
I think so. I really do. I really do think that we have a very good shot at going back and winning and going 3-peat. That's just from the simple fact, yes, they got Roy Hibbert, you know, they got Paul George and those guys, but I think our bench is playing a lot better, and we still haven't played a